Hey everybody, it's your girl Bunny. Join me as I review Fast and Furious presents Hobbs and Shaw, directed by David Leitch, starring Dwayne Johnson, Jason Statham, and Idris Elba. As a bonus, I'll also review the D-Box new and improved cinematic motion experience. Is it worth the money? I'll let you know, coming up next. So to begin, what is this D-Box cinematic motion experience? Well, it's not new technology. It's something that's been out for about 12 years plus, and it allows the viewers to see the movie more as a ride. Everything has a motion to it. If there's a speeding car, you're moving and jolting as if you're in the car. If somebody receives a punch, you receive the jolt in your seat. Now, when I first heard about this, I thought, what's the difference between that D-Box experience and Dolby? Because those of you who have experienced Dolby, it has a little shake to the seat every time that there is some impact or a crescendo of a movie. So I really paid it no mind, and I really didn't want to spend any extra money. But tonight, I wanted to go ahead and experience this with an action film and say, hey, if I don't like the experience, I know not to get it next time. When D-Box was first introduced, a lot of people reported motion sickness, and a lot of people thought that that's because the seats were a little bit further back, because when you would be moving and jolting around, the seats in front of you were completely still, causing your equilibrium to be pretty messed up. So a lot of people declined this offer, and the sales of D-Box tickets started to go down. But since it has been improved, they are putting it in more theaters. What was my experience like? I thought it was absolutely amazing and fun. Then again, I do love roller coasters. Then again, I get sick riding a simple swing at the park. So depends on what you can take. The good thing is that you are able to increase the experience or decrease and absolutely turn it off. So if you spend your money for this D-Box experience and you decide kind of midway through or a couple of seconds into it, you can just cut it off and disable it, and you will not miss your movie and you won't miss out on the experience in its entirety. It was pretty amazing to see the chair lift and turn and move. I can pretty much compare it to maybe a Universal Studio ride where there's a virtual experience and the chair is matching the motion of what you're seeing. Except in this case, the screen is staying completely still and you are enjoying the ride. I would only recommend this D-Box experience for a high intense action movie, Star Wars, Transformers, Fast and Furious, something with high intensity, something that's more dramatic. Probably wouldn't be best to spend the extra money for this technology. Now on to Hobbs and Shaw. So for those of you that don't know, Hobbs and Shaw, they met in Fast and Furious 7. And of course we had Hobbs arrest Shaw based upon a crime, and they've been bumping heads ever since. We have Brixton, played by Idris Elba, who is an MI6 agent gone rogue, and he is on assignment for his superior to capture a deadly virus that can be released anytime, upholding them the power to take control of humanity. This is when Hobbs and Shaw, they must join forces to capture Brixton and to end this mission. Despite its cheesy lines and meaningless monologues, this is a movie for people who just want to see chases, awesome cars, crazy technology, speeds, explosions, and all. It was good to see a movie that didn't take itself too seriously and at the same time had some comedy sprinkles throughout, and then at the same time it didn't suck. It kept your interest all the way to the end and it kept you guessing how it would all come to a close. And to add a few sprinkles on the top, there are a few surprise guest appearances in the movie, which I will not mention because of course this is a review with no spoilers. Overall, I give this movie a 7 out of 10. It gets its 7 because you go in knowing that it's going to be jam-packed with action, not taking itself seriously. You have an idea about the monologues from all of the other Fast and Furious movies, and you're not surprised with something that's disappointing you by not having action in it. The other 3 points are, of course, because there are ridiculous stunts and some things that are not realistic, and you jumping 3,000 feet and catching a helicopter with your arm. It's just things that are just, you look at and you go, yeah, right. right. But at the same time, you're amused because it's fun. You know what you're getting yourself into. So check it out. Comment. Let me know what you think when you see the movie. Are you going to see it? Are you not going to see it? Subscribe. Hit that notification bell so you don't miss any posts. And also follow me on Instagram. Same profile name, officialbun_E. See you later.